Along with providing school education, we also like to provide our children with cultural education so that they understand their place in their wider community, spirituality, and also have a more integrated approach to their future life. One of the very special festivals in Nepal is the Tihar, or also known as Diwali, or the Festival of Lights. And this is a very fun and uplifting celebration, and it generally is held at some point in November. And our children, as all children in Nepal, and actually adults as well, have a public holidays time, usually for 5 days, sometimes longer. And there is a very special tradition in this festival, two key parts that I'll explain here, and you'll see a glimpse in our photographs. And that is, first on the Lakshmi Puja day, which is usually on the evening of the third day, there is a pathway made out of mud and lights and flowers from outside the house into the house to invite Lakshmi, the goddess of light, of abundance and blessings. So offerings are made to her and she's invited into your home. And part of the Lakshmi Puja is also making sure your house is nicely clean. And so there's a fun evening of gathering all together, and as the sun goes down and you light the candles and have some dancing and singing and celebration. On the final day of the festival, there is a special blessing ceremony. And I think this is a very special one for our home in particular, but I think for nearly everyone in Nepal who celebrates this festival. And that is the coming together of sisters giving a blessing for their brothers, and then the brothers giving a blessing for their sisters. And this is a very heartfelt ceremony which really reminds the sisters to really make a beautiful caring and offering to their brothers, but also to remind brothers to look out for and take care for their sisters. So classically, the sisters will make a beautiful plate of sweet treats and fruit and the tasty, delicious food that they know their brother likes and enjoys. And for many people, that will mean cooking for the 2 or 3 days beforehand. And there's a special donut bread called sel roti, made from rice flour and sugar and ghee and deep fried, that is particularly special for this festival. And of course, all our children find it very, very delicious. The purpose of this is to build the relationship between brother and sister. And classically in Nepal, it's also a time when the brothers, particularly if the sisters come from a poor environment and may not have very much, they will gift the sister with money or belongings that she might need, and receiving from the sister the blessing of good food and well-wishing. With our extended family of many brothers and sisters, we find this a very important festival to celebrate together. We hope you've enjoyed a glimpse into our cultural heritage.